Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to walk you through a study that my colleagues and I did back in the summer of 2021. We had a very simple question. We wanted to know what lived on a mountain glacier. To answer this, we got the proper permits in place to put six wildlife cameras on the margins of the Paradise Glacier on the south side of Mount Rainier. Mount Rainier is a heavily glaciated peak in central Washington. It's the tallest mountain in the state. It hosts 26 named glaciers that form the headwaters of five major rivers. Its glaciers are also home to ice worms, one of the most interesting creatures that I've had the pleasure of studying. I'll make an entire video or six about ice worms at some point. So more on that topic later. For this study, we focused on the Paradise Glacier and selected our camera sites based on a fairly direct route between the visitor center and the glacier itself. We generally placed cameras along the margins of the permanent glacier ice, between the rock and the ice, where they would be kind of right on the edge of the glacier. This is a bit of a challenge, though, because Mount Rainier is also one of the snowiest places on Earth. So when we deployed the cameras initially, the landscape looked like this satellite image on the left. But we wanted to be sure that our cameras were actually on the margins of the permanent ice. And so we used a combination of satellite imagery and GPS to make sure that they would be in the right place relative to, say, this image on the right where the snow line is in late August. So we came with a pretty innovative and simple design for our cameras. We essentially used those big coolers that you see at like a kid's soccer game. We covered them in camo duct tape, filled them with snow or rocks once we got to the site. So they were light carrying up, but then they'd be quite heavy. And we mounted the camera to the outside. So we ended up with this camera that would stay in place, but was very well hidden. If you want to read the full published study, I'll put a link to it in the description, but this is the title of it. So, all right, enough background. What did we find? Well, first we had to test the camera. And so thank you to Peter for being the model. And then we saw lots and lots of people. So many people recreate on Mount Rainier at all hours of the day. Before we go any further in this video with these mammal photos and get to the main event of this video, which was in the thumbnail, I want to tell you a little story about this study. So when we set out to do this, we were thinking about how we were designing this study and how we were going to do the cameras. And we talked about at some point, I said something along the lines of, what if we got a wolverine on our camera? Like, wouldn't that be incredible? And we knew that wolverines are exceptionally rare in this area. And, it was kind of the holy grail of what might show up. And Lo and behold, as you'll see in the next few photos, we not only saw wolverines, we got amazing photos of wolverines. We have wolverines, an adult mom, which we now know is the mom of two kits. So we have an entire wolverine family, a wolverine chews on our camera. It was just amazing stuff. This was actually the second family of wolverines seen in the Southern Cascade Mountains in over 100 years. And for those of you that don't know about wolverines and are wondering why I'm so excited about it, they are the phantoms of the alpine ecosystem. Plenty of mountain recreators go their whole lives being in places in wolverine country, in wolverine terrain, and never seeing one. I've spent over 12 years studying high elevation ecosystems, spending hundreds of days in the field in places with high densities or relatively high densities of wolverines. And I've still only seen two wolverines live in the wild. And so this just highlights the power of this kind of study. I mean, these are places where people don't put wildlife cameras very often. And so even with our relatively small scale effort, we captured some really amazing data, some really important photographs, and we were really proud of the effort and the publication that came out of it.